Now we will see different types of options in formula tab. First, we will see the options in function library group. Here we have different types of functions. With the help of these options, we can perform all types of functions in each category. When we click on the option Insert Function, then we will get a dialog box. Here we have to select category. If we select all, then it will shows all types of functions. And if we select this one, then it will shows functions which we used recently. If we want only financial functions, then we have to select the category financial. Like that, we can also select math and trigonometry functions, etc. When we select a particular function, then we can see its description and parameters. For example, ABS, within the bracket we have given number, and it is the description that explains what type of function will work. Press OK button. Now we have to give parameter, and here we can see that which type of number should be given. Number is the real number for which you want the absolute value. For example, I am giving minus 45, and it shows the value 45 without any signs. Here itself we can see its result. When we press OK button, then the result will shows in the selected cell. We can also give functions directly in the cell. For example, equal to A, then it will shows a list of function which starts with the letter A in alphabetical order. Like that, if we give B, then it will shows a list of functions which starts with the letter B. So I am giving equal to ABS within the brackets minus 56. Press Enter key. Now it shows the result. So if we know the function, then we can give its parameters directly in the cell, and there is no need to select the option Insert Function. Next, select Insert Function Financial category, and here I am selecting this function to find out the depreciation. Here we have 5 parameters. Last parameter, that is factor, is optional, so it shows as a dull. But we should give these 4 parameters compulsorily. We can observe that when we click on the particular parameter, then it will shows its description. We can also give reference, so we have to click on it. And here I am selecting this cell. Like this, we can give reference if already we have data in the sheet. And we can also give values directly. Now I am cancelling this one. Like this, we have to give parameters. In Insert Function, we have all categories. And here it shows like this. For example, I am selecting sum, and here it shows formula sum of D2:D10. Like this, we can use functions like average, count, maximum, minimum. And if we select more functions, then it will shows Insert Function dialog box. Here it shows some of the categories separately, like financial, logical functions, etc. Now we will see that how the functions will work. Here we have hundreds of functions. Among them, I am selecting math and trigonometry function. Here we have functions like cos, sine, etc. For example, I am selecting fact. Here I am giving value 5 and now it shows the factorial value 120. If you want any help, then we have to click on the option help on this function. Then it will explain clearly that how to use that function and it shows with examples. For example, I am selecting financial function and here I am selecting DB. Returns the depreciation of an asset for a specified period using the fixed declaring balance method. This function is used to find out the depreciation in fixed declaring balance method. These are the parameters. For example, we have purchased computer for 20,000 rupees. It is the cost. Cost is the initial cost of an asset. Next one is salvage. Salvage is the salvage value at the end of the life of an asset. So I am giving salvage value as a 5000. Its lifetime is 5 years. Next we have to give period, that at which year we have to find the depreciation value. I am giving 5th year and here it shows the depreciation value 1597 rupees. In first period, we have large amount of depreciation, that is 4840 rupees. Like this, we have to find the depreciation value for the particular period. Next, I am selecting future value. It is used to find the future value of an investment. Here, I am giving interest rate 5%. Number of periods 5, payment for each period 1000 rupees. This is the final value. And if we increase the interest rate, then the future value will also increase. Like this, we can operate the financial functions. In same way, we can use statistical functions like average, average deviation, etc. Now I am selecting average deviation. Here I am giving some numbers. Like this, we can use different types of functions. In database category, we have functions like sum, average, count, etc. But here we have to give database. For example, I am selecting these columns. Next, we have to give field, that for which column we have to calculate. I am selecting basic. And last one is criteria. It means the range includes a column label. I am selecting this column and now it shows the database average. This function is similar to the average function, but here we have to set the criteria, and if we select the average function, then it will select the column automatically. Like this, we have to use database functions. And it has same procedure for all functions. Next, I am selecting text. Here I am selecting length. And we should give text in double quotations. Hello world. And its length is 11 characters. So, these functions are work based on the text. Like this, we have functions like left write, etc. Next, I am selecting lookup and reference column. Here we have to give reference, then it will show the column number 4. Next function is information. Here we have functions like is blank, is error, etc. I am selecting this function and this cell is blank, so it shows true, otherwise it shows false. Next we have an important function, logical. This function is used to calculate the logical calculations. For example, if you want to find student result and class, now we have to find that whether the student is pass or fail. If the student gets more than 35 in these 4 subjects, then he is pass, otherwise fail. So I am giving formula equal to if. In if condition, we have 3 parameters. First one is logical test. If logical test is true, then it will show true value. And if it is false, then it will show false value. So we have to give logical test true value and false value. For example, if C2 greater than or equal to 35, pass, otherwise fail. Here, Telugu marks is more than 35, so it shows pass. And we should consider all subject marks to find whether the student is pass or fail. So, we have to give if D2 greater than equal to 35, if E2 greater than or equal to 35, if F2 greater than or equal to 35. True parameter is added for all these conditions. We have placed pass and fail for F2. This is the true value for E2. And here we have to give false value for E2. Next, we have to give false value for D2 and C2. It means, if a student gets less than 35 marks in any one of the subject, then it will show the result as a fail, otherwise it shows pass. We should give commas, brackets carefully. Now drag this symbol towards down. Here we can see some students have failed and they got less than 35 marks. Next we have to give class. So I am giving formula. If I2 equal to pass, comma, if H2 greater than or equal to 60, first class, if H2 greater than or equal to 50, second class, otherwise third. Now we have closed this condition. Next I am closing first condition. And finally, if I2 is not pass, then it shows as a no class. This condition is closed here and this condition is closed at last. Now we have to drag it towards down. Like this, we have to calculate result and class through if condition. And we can also calculate result and class by using AND condition. For example, I am giving AND condition here. Next, we have to remove all these if conditions. And there is no need to give all these things. So, if all these conditions are true, then it will show the result pass. Otherwise, it shows fail. Like this, we can use AND condition.